Hello everyone. Welcome back to Pharma Guideline. In today's session, we are diving into a very important topic addressing equipment failure in pharmaceutical manufacturing processes. This is something every pharma professional will face at some point, and understanding how to handle it can make all the difference in maintaining product quality, compliance, and safety. First things first, what exactly do we mean by equipment failure? In simple terms, equipment failure is any situation where a machine or device used in the manufacturing process does not perform as intended. This could be a breakdown, an operational error, a calibration issue, or even a simple wear and tear malfunction. Now, in a pharmaceutical environment, the consequences of equipment failure can be very serious. We are talking about potential batch rejections, production delays, deviations, or worse, compliance issues with regulatory authorities like the FDA or EMA. One of the most important aspects of handling equipment failure is early detection. That's why routine inspections, preventive maintenance, and automated monitoring systems are so crucial. Let's say, for example, you are using a granulator and you notice abnormal vibration or noise. That's a red flag. Don't wait. Stop and investigate. Always remember that the sooner you identify the problem, the faster you can contain the risk. Once a failure occurs, the next critical step is root cause analysis. We are not just fixing the problem, we are finding out why it happened. One effective tool we use is the 5 whys method. You keep asking why until you reach the underlying cause. For example, why did the tablet press stop? Because the motor overheated. Why did it overheat? Because the cooling fan wasn't working. Why wasn't the fan working? Because the power supply was interrupted. Why was there a power interruption? Because of poor electrical maintenance. Why is maintenance poor? Because there's no preventive maintenance schedule. As you can see, the issue is much deeper than just a broken machine. This is how real solutions are developed. Implementing corrective and preventive actions. After identifying the root cause, we need to put in place corrective and preventive actions, also known as CAPA. Corrective action deals with the immediate fix. Preventive action ensures that the issue doesn't happen again. For example, correcting the electrical fault is a corrective action. But creating a documented, routine maintenance plan, that's your preventive action. Documentation and compliance. Documentation is non-negotiable. Every failure, investigation, and CAPA must be recorded clearly. This is not just for internal learning, it's also a compliance requirement. Regulators like the FDA want to see evidence that you understand your processes, that you learn from failures, and that your systems are continuously improving. Final tips for success. Before we wrap up, here are a few golden rules. Always train your operators to report anomalies immediately. Use checklists and logbooks to track equipment performance. Schedule preventive maintenance and stick to it. Never skip documentation. Use your deviation reports as learning tools. Remember, equipment failure isn't just a problem to fix, it's an opportunity to strengthen your system. When handled correctly, it can actually improve your manufacturing process and build trust with regulatory bodies. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel to get regular updates. Join channel membership to access exclusive content like courses and member-specific videos.